Power monitoring was never this easy. This is the Zemismart Smart Power Meter. This is the Zemismart Power Meter. The model is SPM01. Let's open the box up. Inside, you will find the meter and an instruction manual. According to the manual, you can install this meter both before and after the breaker. And the principle is pretty simple. This is a neutral and a phase connection. By connecting these two wires to your fuse and probably the null bar, you will be powering on the device and also allow the device to monitor the input voltage, while the phase wire will need to go through this coil over here, and this will allow monitoring of the active current passing through the wire. At the end, we have a status indicator, a button to pair it with your Zigbee network, and a flow direction. Always connect this unit pointing to the consumer. If you connect it the other way around, it will register as an energy generating system like a solar panel or a battery. Let's install it and see how it works. As you can see, I already connected two of these devices. This is one and this is the second one. The black wire over here is connected to the phase, and the blue wire is piggybacking the neutral over here on the second pole. Both devices, as you can see, have a solid green LED, which means that they are connected to Zigbee to MQTT. All I have to do now is hide these wires and close back the panel. All right, the panel is back up and we're good to go. Going back to Home Assistant, Zigbee to MQTT, we can find the two newly added devices. Let's go to one of them, let's say this one. It is a router type. It has been added directly with the included driver, so no extra settings required. And if we go to exposes, we can see the current voltage, we can see the amp draw, and we will see here the power usage. In this case, there's something very small connected, so it's barely 5 watts. Now let's go to energy, go to settings, energy configuration. We can add consumption. First one will be bathroom power monitor energy. We also have produced energy, but this is used only if we have some batteries or solar panels. Use a static price, in my case is 0.8. Perfect. Add consumption. Now we need to add the kitchen energy, static price, same 0.8. And done. Now we'll be able to track the energy consumption all over the house. That's it for this short video. If you enjoyed it, please don't forget to like and subscribe.